She's played the president, tackled Julius Caesar and King Lear, and now Elizabeth Marvel is raising hell on the new series, starring as a demonic mother. Take a look.
What did you say to that nurse? What is this symbol? What does it mean?
Not quite a Picasso, is it?
A man was murdered last night.
People kill. They have since the dawn of time. They need to maintain the balance. You, more than anyone, should know that.
What did you say to the nurse and those two patients? Where did you send them?
To see an old friend.
And Elizabeth joins me now. Oh my God, I love this show.
I'm so glad.
I was so, okay, I'm going to watch the first episode and then, you know, that would be
and
good.
And you got sucked in.
I got sucked in. And so before this interview, I was running a little bit late because I was trying to get through the second episode. Just awesome. Talk to me about what drew you to this. Like, how did you end up with this role? Because it is so yummy, I would guess.
It is. It's complete actor candy. I mean, you know, I get to play all of the keys on the piano. I get to go up and down the scales because on the one hand, I'm this very nurturing, loving mother. And on the other hand, I am the source of all demonic power.
And that sums it up.
And that's it in a nutshell.
Tell me about your two characters that's within, you know, one body.
Mm-hmm.
So, audience, who you play.
Sure. I play Victoria Helstrom, who is the mother of these two adult children, Damon and Anna, who I was in a very horrifying relationship with their father, who was a very dark presence. I won't unpack the whole backstory of that because that's fun for the viewers to discover what that is. But when they were very young, a horrible trauma happened in the family and sort of split us all apart. And I basically became possessed and have been kept separate because I now contain otherworldly powers of the dark universe. And they dominate me most of the time.
You know, just for folks who have not seen this, you
sure.
know, there's no special effects. I mean, it really
a little. There's a little.
Well, no, I mean, as far as what you do as an actor bring on this character, like, how do you go so dark?
It's so funny. It's funny because, you know, people ask like, oh my gosh, you must have been depressed doing this or in a very weird place. And it's like, it's not true. When I have to go to deeper, darker territory, it usually makes me feel much lighter and happier. And so it's really relaxing in a weird way. And this character, it's sort of like when you play the king, you know, don't do anything. It's how other people deal with you that makes you the king. I learned a lot about stunt work. I'll tell you that.
Yeah, I bet you did.
There are some wild stunts that I got to do, which was because as you said, what you see is pretty much me doing what you're seeing.
Yeah. How'd you pull off that voice, the demonic voice? When I first heard it, I was like listening. I was like, is that her?
It's totally me. I'll tell you, I screamed into a pillow for many hours.
I do want to ask you about another project that you're working with Tom Hanks on, and I saw the trailer for this.
This movie is set in the West just as the Civil War is ending. And Tom plays a man. At the time, there were people that would travel from town to town in more remote towns, and they would gather all the newspapers and sort of go and read the headlines to the town. They'd deliver the news of the world and everyone would gather in the town square and you know, give him a penny. And it was a job. And so that's who he is playing. And I think it's very reflective of the moment we're in as a country. I think it'll really speak to people. And it's also beautifully shot. And I think people really, really love it.
Well, I want to let everybody know because I got to get back to my my TV watching.
You're viewing.
Thanks to you. Let's wrap this up. So all episodes of Helstrom are streaming on Hulu right now. Elizabeth, it has been a pleasure.
Likewise.
It was lovely talking to you.
Likewise. Thank you.